We are back here at Missouri Wind and Solar, where we are talking about something that seems technical, but it's super easy to understand, and it is not an art class. Wes, what do we have going on right here?
Absolutely. So thanks for coming out today, Mason. What we are talking about in the solar world, we use the terminology angle of declination.
Okay.
And that's just a big phrase for where's the sun?
All right.
And what we're going to look at here today is my really fantastic drawing of the Earth. And if we're here in Springfield, Missouri, then what we're looking at is the sun, which is, I know this doesn't look like the sun, this is actually stolen from Lucy. What we're looking at is where the sun is in relation to where you are on Earth. And so what happens is, if we're right now in the middle of February, 1st of March, so the sun is appearing very low. And so what happens is, as we go through the year, then the sun is going to appear higher and higher. And so what happens is, you have in Springfield, around here, you have upwards of a 20 degree difference in that angle of declination.
Okay.
So basically what's happening is, you're not getting as efficient of use out of your solar panels unless you're adjusting your solar panels to where the sun is in that arc.
Okay.
And so we've got just one of our little portable USB solar chargers, and again Lucy's ball. So what we're looking at is if your panels are just mounted static like this, which is real, you know. And so if you're in winter, well, you see you're not getting a straight on. And then in summer, it's kind of the same thing. So what we want to do is, as that change happens over the season, we want to adjust where the panels are pointed so that you're always getting a maximum amount of sunlight on there.
Making it more efficient
More efficient. Because you can, like I said, you've got, I think it's about a 20 degree difference, which can equate to, if I remember my numbers right, that can actually work out to about a 30% loss or change in what your panels are actually producing.
Okay, and I know that you guys have some mounts that will actually follow the sun, but just in case you don't have one of those, you are gonna show us how you can adjust them yourself.
So we're gonna walk out to one of our ground mounts and just see how easy it is to do that. And like we were talking earlier, you at least wanna do this at winter and summer.
Okay.
A lot of our people who are relying on, you know, off-gridders, that sort of thing, who have to rely on it very significantly, can make these changes even like once a month. Because that, again, that changing in that that power output is that significant. So minimum, you know, spring and fall sort of thing, but as often as once a month. And there are a lot of solar calculators out there. I think the one I use is I think it's suncalc.org that actually give you the percentages. There's a ton of them out there. You can just Google that. It'll tell you where to point to make sure you're getting the maximum exposure on your panels.
All right. Well, let's step outside and check it out.
All right. Let's go. We're in our showroom here. This is one of our roof mount systems. And we've actually got a couple solar panels mounted up here just for display. But this gives a good example of the adjustability of these floor mount systems, roof mount systems. So what you would do is that number of times a year, however many times it is, again, at least you want to do it in the spring and fall sort of thing. You simply come in here and you would loosen up this bolt. And in this case, you loosen up this bolt and that whole unit could just slide up. In this case, it's pretty much set in a winter position. And by sliding it up to more of a horizontal position, then you'd be moving into the summer position. And it's just that easy. So loosen two bolts, tighten them back up, and you're good to go. And that's pretty much what you would need to do to swap those in and out for each season.